Hello, members of CEOs Hub. Yeah, I decided to provide this solution, today being Solution Wednesday. I decided to provide this solution for those of us who does not know how to make a Google form. Google form is like a kind of free to use online form. For those of us who know a little about programming and coding, you would understand that making a form online is a back-end stuff and it requires a lot of coding knowledge. But it has been made easy by Google such that even anybody who could use Facebook could make a Google form for their own advantage. Like as a businessman, you or women, you need to take your people to take your customers online, whereby anywhere they want to assess your goods or service, you could actually contact them via social media, WhatsApp, Google, Skype, whichever way. But you need to get their data, you need to get their information down. Of course, you can get their information on Facebook Messenger, you can get it on WhatsApp. But the advantage of Google Form is that it is designed in such a way whereby you can keep record in Excel format. And you know, Excel format is a tool that you can use for analysis, you can use for whatever in the future. So that's the advantage of sending your client or your whatever prospect online to fill a form via Google Form, which is totally free as far as you have a Gmail account. So that's the essence of this tutorial today. How to make a Gmail account, I want to believe we all know that, so I won't be going through that. How to link that up to all your accounts, it will be another tutorial for another day. But quickly, let us go into the main topic for today, which is how to make a Google form. The first thing you have to do is you go to your browser. Mostly it should be done on a computer system, but for those of us who doesn't have a computer system, it's also very flexible in such a way that you can do it on your tablet, on your smartphone, or any phone that can access the internet and have Google Chromecast installed on it. More so, you can use whatever software, but I recommend Google Chromecast, or at worst use Mozilla Firefox, because Mozilla Firefox also operates on Google software, Chromecast software. They are integrated and so powerful. Now I go to Google Chromecast on my phone by clicking the Google Chromecast icon. Yes, you can see it's launched. Then I try to type the URL. URL means it's also the same thing as website address. So what I'll type this URL, forms.google.com. After typing, I click on go. Then when I click on go, the form will come up. Yes, the form is coming up. Oh, sorry, I have an error there, so the form will not come up. forms.google.com. So the form will come up. When the form comes up, you would now begin to manipulate the form to your interest. Now, while the form is coming up, I have to advise that whatever form you are making, you have to make it in black and white at first. You have to have a drafted form, maybe via your Microsoft Word format, or via your notepad on phone, or on the Windows, your PC, or iOS stuff. Or even at worst, if you don't have a laptop, you can actually just get your biro and your paper, then draft a form the way you want it to look like. So that is what will form exactly how your form looks online. Yeah, quickly, sorry, I had to attend to some things. Quickly, we have the form loaded now. The first thing you have to do is to create a title for the form and find a way to save the form. So let's take, for example, I'm naming the form application form. Let's say creating an application form for my ICT students, and I want them to go to Google Form to fill the form online. Automatically, you will discover that the browser would load by itself. Every step you take into the form, you would get the browser loading. So let me say this is application form for my for IT students interested in my program. Okay, so there are two options there. You see the question section and the responses section. If you go to the responses section, that's where you, as the builder of the form, you would get all responses so far. But that's, by the way, we'll come back to that. You, the application form, you've given the description. Now, what you have to now do is that you go to the untitled form and you title the form. If you look at the space, the title of the form is still not titled. And to do that, you click on the title and automatically it brings the initial title here. The initial title here, it brings it and place it here. But now, you can decide to save it that way and click go. And you can decide to save it the other way. Now, let's just continue. I've saved it as application form. And you will see that here on the browser name, it is also known as application form. It has changed automatically. Now, the next thing is, before we go into this real question section, you would want to, let's say, customize your form in such a way that people would like it. You don't want it to be purple the way it is here. You want it to be your corporate logo, or the design you have given to a graphic designer, or you have done yourself. You have it on your browser or on your phone or on your laptop or whichever way you have it. So the next thing you have to do is to go to the to change that. You click on the theme. Currently you see a ticked purple stuff, and going back you see that it is purple. So you click on that platelet icon. The platelet icon will lead you to options. The header, for the header. So the header, you can choose your customized image. You can choose for the background color. You can choose whatever color. But you can only change the image of the header. You can see here that this section is the header section. Why this section is the body section? For those of us who are into programming, you would understand what we call body and the header. Now, on the header section, I want to customize to my own choice image. I click on that option to select from my device. So it will bring me a lot of customized options. We have pre-installed images that you can use without having trouble on Google Form. You can use these candies, these guitar strings, if you want to. If, let's say, the form you are creating is for those who wants to learn music, for those who like a church, you can see there's a Bible there. For those who are into makeup business, you can see brushes. You know, something related to what you actually do will be the best. For footballers, you can see goal net and others. So you can pick around this array of options. But in case you are still not satisfied and you have your own specific header image that you wish to use, you can just simply click the option available for you. Mind you, in the course of creating the image, there are image sizes that are required. So you just go to upload photos. When you click on upload photos, it tells you drag a photo here. If you are on PC, you can drag your photo from the file folder and drag into the Google Form menu. But if you want to just simply select a photo from your computer, this is best option for those of us on phone. You cannot drag on phone, you know that. But I don't know of high-end phones like iOS phones or whatever, but on Android phone, you cannot drag into a browser. So you have to just select a photo from your computer. I click on select from my computer. Select from your computer. then you see the options, they are out. I click on document, or if I want to take a camera photo, that's not going to be the best quality. It brings me to my driver being a Google account holder. Everybody on Google has a Google Drive as the cloud platform where all your informations are stored. So, but because this is very a bit technical, I have a ES File Explorer here, so I can just go to my ES File Explorer. But to make it easy, I go to the gallery option. So when I click on the gallery option here, it brings me a lot of options. Let's say, this is MedPorter, one of my products for hospital management for those of us who have medical doctors that needs to automate their hospitals. You have it, you have the MedPorter that will work for you there. Okay, let me just integrate MedPorter into this form. Okay, now I have chosen MedPorter graphics on my phone, and it's uploading. When it's done uploading, it gives me, you can see there's a frame size expected. You cannot go beyond that frame size, so you can only expand it. So let's say I have chosen MedPorter here, or just the MedPorter logo the way it is. I can bring it down to the logo alone this way. Now I now click on select. When it's selected, it uploads. That's for the customization aspect. You don't necessarily have to customize your Google form, you can just adopt whatever option. So you can see the option that image uploaded. So the image is uploaded. You can also now come to the background color section here. You can choose any color to meet or suit your background choice. Then the font style, the body font, what style do you want your Google form to have? We have just four options as at this time of doing this video. We have the basic, we have the decorative, the formal, and the playful. So let's just go with the playful. Okay, the playful. Now I click on apply. After clicking on apply, it has been applied to my form. If you can see on the header section, it has changed from purple and giving me my MedPorter logo. And the body section have also changed color from the lilac color. It has now given me a sky blue color, and that suits my background image up there. That makes it very fanciful and interesting to have. Now I want to go into the real application form section. This is the most technical part of creating a Google form. Now it has brought me the first option. You can see untitled question. I just come here, I bring my option up here, then I clear that and put a question. Are you interested in my product? Interested in my product? Then the answer could either be yes, no, or maybe. Now, if I want, it has brought me suggestions. You will see suggestions here telling me to add all. I can choose not to add all. I can choose to just name my option, the expected answers to my question the way I have it. For those of us who does research and you know a little about survey, you would know that we have open-ended question and closed-ended questions. So, but this time around, we'll be using both open and closed-ended question in this application form. So I can click on add all. By clicking on add all, it will bring me the three options of yes, no, or maybe. If I don't want maybe, I just cancel it. It has the option of yes and no into it. If I want to add another, maybe I want to name that other thing. So I can just put other or whatever. Now, we have a section here. This is the powerhouse of the response. The powerhouse of the response is here. So you click on the drop-down menu. It drops down. We have short answer. We have paragraph. We have multi-choice. We have checkboxes. We have drop-down, file upload, linear scale, multi-choice grid, tick box grid, date, time. Now, I will quickly run through each one of them. When you click on short answer, it gives the person with the option a very short answer of not more than, say, 50 text to type in at least something like of that range. But when you, if you want the person to write a textbook, a story, very long story to give you the answer, you click on paragraph. You click on the paragraph menu, it gives you a long answer text. You can see it in the description. It's a long answer text. Then you can, you, if you go to the multi-choice, of course, we've tried the multi-choice whereby you have the option of yes, no, maybe option one. Like if I go to option one here now, I can call option one cake, then go to add another. I call the second, the another, I call it pastries. Let's call it pastries. No, something like that. Let's not waste our time on that. You can keep adding. Then you go to check boxes too. Like for those of us who have installed an application, either on phone or on PC or whichever way, you would notice that there is always the tick box option of you abide by our terms and conditions. You can create something like that with the check boxes. Then you can also have a drop down menu. Well, you see the drop down menu is just like image, where you can add image as options to your answer. So you can see the same process of uploading image. This is where you upload image from your device. This is where you take a snapshot with your camera. This is where, if you have a link online that you want to bring in the image, you bring in the, you insert the image by your URL, which is the website address. If you click on it, it will bring you to type in the paste an image URL here. That is the website address where the image is inserted. I don't know, your albums, the Google Drive, for those of us who knows Google Drive, how to use Google Drive, you know. That's, by the way, let's quickly go to other options. That's for those of us who wants to add different image as the options for our Google form. Okay, so sorry, we have now the way it is now. Some of us will think, oh, I'm confused, I don't know where to go next. So we have menu here too, down, oh sorry, we have menus down here too. You can see menus. We have the add button here, we have the text button here, we have the image button here if you want to add image, we have the video button here, and we also have the break section button. The break section button too is there. Sorry, the network is, we are in Nigeria, so the network is not as good as you would always find it everywhere. So so let's just go back to, yeah, sorry for the break in transmission. Yeah, we are back to that now. The options are out. You, that's the drop down option I explained earlier. Then we have the file upload option. If you click on the file upload option, people can begin to upload their files into your form. You know, all this information on your form stores on your Google Drive account as an Excel document, as an Excel file format document. So let respondents upload files. You can see here, let respondents upload files to Drive. Files will be uploaded to form owner's Google Drive. Respondents will be required to sign in to Google when file upload questions are added to form. Okay, sorry. Let's go back to that. So, you know, in the course of touching the sensitive parts of the form, you know, I make mistakes. So you just take it that way. Now, let's go to other options. We have the linear scale, multi-choice grid, tick box grid. You can play around it. Like if you want people to add their birth date, or the day they want to do something, or the day they want you to deliver a good, or the day you, or what, whichever way, the day they are expecting, you just click on the date options. It gives you an option. It gives the people who, your target customers or target persons the option to select the date the specific date. I have actually used all these options and I know it works very, very fine, perfectly. So let me quickly, because of our time and the space to download, let me quickly run through the fact that we have the required section here. So you can click on required. For those of us who have filled a form online, you will see that there is always a red star in some questions, a red star above. That means without the person answering the question, without the person giving an answer to such question, the person cannot progress. But if you don't click required, that person can avoid the question and not necessarily answer it. So if I click on required here, so now we have options under required too. You can show description for your question. Let's say the question you set up, you think people might not get the question very well. You want them to understand it better. So you click on description. When you click on description, it brings the description option. Are you interested in my product? Let me say that is, do you want to buy my goods and services. So that's just a description that you don't know. So you can come back to that menu again and include the specific time for this mean that I selected the date option. You can include a specific time. Take for example, somebody wants something at a specific time. So you want that person to have the option of giving you the specific time that good service or product should be delivered. So you just click on that. Now, I can now continue from there. I click on the hard button for the next question. Like that. So let's say the next question is, Agbo is crazy. Oh, okay. Let's say Agbo is funny. Okay. Now, Agbo is funny is not a good question in this format. Now, I don't want it again. I want to delete it. So I just click on the delete button. If I want this question repeated the way it is, let's say I don't want to stress myself. I want this same format in the next question. I just click on copy. It takes me to the question and gives highlights the question itself if I want it that way. So, but I don't want it that way. I just want the format I set earlier to be that way. So I can now go to Agbo is funny. You know, so you can continue playing around the questions. So when you click on the text menu, it takes you, you can see now, untitled title. So it takes you to the next option for you to type in. So I don't want it, I click on delete. So I can also add image. I told you. Now, let's say I have done my question down. I have made the required, the unrequired, you know, I've done the necessary setup. But I want people to be taking. I don't want the question to be too long. Say I have about 30 questions. You know, nowadays, people find a lot of things very, very, very boring. So you just have to break your question into sections. Let's say one section is for introduction. Let's say the personal data of the person who have answered the question. Then the next question is into other important sections. You just click on this last button that breaks it into section 1, section 2, section 3, section whatever. So we have continued to next section. So you also have the option here, go to section 1, application form, go to section 2, yet title. So at section 2 now, you can also create a title the way it is, application form. Let's now say this, my section 2 is personal biodata, you know, like that. You create the form that way too. So that's it. That's how to create a form in a simple and easy method. We don't have to create a form here for you to see. Now, after you are done creating the form, if you wish to manipulate the settings of the whole form, we have 3 bar menu buttons here. You can see me clicking it. It's beside my Google account login. My Google account, as you can see, is here. It's here. Now, it's beside my Google account login. So now, after doing that, you can manipulate the settings, get the field link, print the form. Yes, with this print the form option, you can
not for those of us who doesn't want to place it online, you just want the Google Form style. You want to design with your Google Form into PDF format, and you want to print it and give to people. But you don't want to use your Microsoft Word to design the form because you like Google Form the way it's structured. You can just come to this print option here and then click on it, and you get it printed directly from your computer or from your printer attached to your computer. But me, being that this is a phone, I don't have a printer attached to this phone, so it automatically brings me to save as PDF. It saves as PDF. So you click on print again. It brings me to, after preparing the print, it brings me to save as PDF. So when I save as PDF, it will save my document as a PDF. If I save it, but I don't want to save it. So now, once I'm done, I want to publish my Google Form. It is perfect. I want to now give the link to people to now begin to see my form. As I told you earlier, we have the responses section. Responses, this is the question section, is divided into two. So if I click on responses, that's where I see the number of respondents, their answers and everything. This interface is for the person who made the form. It's not for the interface the person who sees the form would preview or see. No, the person can only see the question. The person cannot see. The person can see responses, but not an overall view like that. So to publish it, there's an arrow here. There's a kind of flight icon here by the platelet menu and everything. You just click on that flight stuff. As you can see, here comes the send form option. Are you sending forms to people through through your email, or do you want to just get your form link and share on social media, on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, whatever? Then again, you have the option of embedding it. For those of us who are into coding, you put it in an iframe, the form will appear the way you have designed it in your website or in your mobile application. So you can also share on Google, on Facebook, on Twitter. But if you come back to, we mostly use the link option. The link option is the best, so that social media is the easiest place to reach to your people. So you put it that way. Now, another thing is that there's always a long URL people are, you know, they find it too stressed and too difficult, you know, when the numbers are just too confusing, and so it's not friendly to share a long URL link. So you can shorten your URL. It is the option to shorten your URL. You can see, after clicking the shorten URL, it has a very simple and short code, a short URL link. So you can now click on copy. You can see, you can either press Control plus C on your computer, or you just click on copy on your phone. Now I have copied to clipboard. I have copied my link. With this, I've been able to publish my Google form. Now if I share this link to with you and you click it, it will take you down online. It will take the user online to my Google form the way I have designed it to be. And once they fill the form and click on submit, it will come back into my home responses here and bring it down. Now before I go, I have to teach you how to now assess information. After it is like this, what else, what next? How do you now download it? Because of course you cannot just have it online and not be able to use it for your business or personal or church or whatever advantage. So there's this icon here, a green icon here, that is the Excel format icon. So you can just click on that button. Simply, it tells you create a new spreadsheet. It's because I have created several Google Forms, I have select existing spreadsheets. So if I click on that and I select it, it will take me down to that means you can update your existing form to look the way you now want it to look. You don't have to, like, you know, just stress yourself. You just attach it
to the existing spreadsheet, but now I want to create an existing spreadsheet. If I create, automatically the system will do what it ought to do. So that's by the way. Now, you now go to the menu here. You can also download responses in .csv format. You can see the menu here. So all the responses you later review as the creator of the Google form, once you click on download responses, it will take you into your Google Drive and download it in .csv format, which is an Excel format. Then you can, if it is on laptop, we have the print all responses, so you don't have to download, you just print it. But Google is so smart, they understand that not everybody has a laptop, not everybody has the time to sit with a laptop, not everybody likes to be on the computer system on their PC. So you can just print all the responses directly. So it's there. We also have the unlink form. If you want to bring down the form, you just click on unlink form. So you can also direct your response destination to maybe an email address, so that, you know, some of us have Gmail accounts that immediately messages comes in for your business or for your whatever, it alerts you on your phone, it brings it out in the push notification menu on your phone, then you know that, okay, people are actually filling my form, people are responding. So you can just select response destination and put your business link. So that's it. That's how to make a Google form. And I believe that this would have been of advantage to you. Thank you for listening. I will do some other recordings soon. Thank you.